your girl Jackie, and before I get into today's review, I have some really exciting news to share with you guys. Those of you who follow me on Facebook and Twitter probably already know this, and if you're not following me there, hello, why not? I got the links all down below. This is how you keep up with what I'm doing, okay? Because I'm crazy and I'm always doing something. But I was asked to do a guest blog for none other than Stila Cosmetics, okay? Yes, that's Stila. The one you find at Sephora and at Macy's and all these other places, that's Stila, okay? I am so excited. Like, I still can't even believe it happened. So I was asked to do a guest blog for them. The blog is already up. I'm going to put the link down below. Go check it out. It's called My Stila Story. So it's basically my personal experience with Stila, and I talk about how I got started blogging and how I used the Stila Smoky Eye Talking Palettes. Those of you guys have been following me since the beginning know I used those palettes for like the first 6 months. It's like the only eyeshadow I used because I couldn't afford to buy anything else. So I talked about that, and there's like a Q&A with me, and there's like a big old picture of me, which I'm just like, oh my god, I cannot believe that on the Stila site there's a big old picture of my face, okay? I'm still tripping out. But anyways, I want to say thank you to you guys, first of all, because if I didn't have viewers and readers and all of that, none of the amazing things that happened to me would be happening, and I owe it all to you guys. Thank you for being so loyal to me and always watching my videos and checking out my channel and, you know, reading my blog. I love you guys so much, you don't even know. Like, if someone had told me 2.5 years ago when I started blogging that my face would be on the Stila site one day, I would have been like, yeah, right, okay, whatever. And it happened. So thank you guys so much. I love you guys so much. And right in the middle of this touchy moment that we're having right now, I'm opening up to you guys, and I'm having a moment here. There's a bus stop right outside my house, and some fool is sitting on the bench playing the damn harmonica, okay? So I'm having a touching moment, and I really hope that you guys cannot hear this horrible harmonica playing in the background. Who plays a harmonica? What the hell is this, like 1925? Who plays he's off key too, because that don't sound good. He needs a tune up on that thing or something. I don't even know. Okay, so anyways, let's get right into the review before this fool breaks out with a banjo and I have to go outside and whoop his ass. So anyways, what we're gonna be talking about today is Benefit's brand new mascara called They're Real, and this actually came out I think like about a month ago or so. I originally saw it, actually I think it was on the Home Shopping Network that they were talking about it. This was around June, and they released just like a limited amount only for the Home Shopping Network, and they made the rest of us wait, okay? I don't know why, like I'm not special or something. So anyways, I finally got my hands on some. I've been wearing this for about 2 weeks now, and you know that I love to tell you guys right away what I think before I get into it. I love it. I'm absolutely impressed with this mascara. You guys know that I'm a mascara junkie. I review mascaras all the time, and you know that one of my biggest pet peeves is when a mascara does not live up to the hype, when it doesn't live up to what the company says about it. It always upsets me and gets on my nerves. I have to say that this is probably the first time that a mascara has actually lived up to the marketing, and I'm so excited about it. So first of all, okay, I'm gonna show you guys like on the packaging, they have all this like writing about like what's going on with the mascara, and there's like a before and after on all this, and I normally don't even bother with that, but because it's accurate, I'm just like, oh my god, like something's accurate. They actually marketed something in an accurate way. So let me give you a little background on the mascara. According to their website, they've been developing this for like 3 or 4 years, I think it said, and they want to see, and here's the other thing I like about this, and I complained about this on the last mascara review I did for Maybelline, the Falsies Flared mascara, which I liked. Remember I told you guys I like that mascara, but they promised that it was gonna make lashes look fake, and it didn't. Benefit was very careful with their wording here, which I actually appreciate. At no point do they say that this is going to make your lashes look fake. What they said is they look beyond real. So like right here it says real and beyond real. So they're not promising us that our lashes are gonna look fake. So right away they've been truthful, which I really appreciate. But if I'm being honest, when you're wearing this mascara, it really does look beyond real. It doesn't quite look fake because, like I've always said, the only thing that's gonna make you look like you're wearing false lashes is wearing false lashes. But this really makes your lashes look so much more dramatic. It looks like you have so many more lashes. This is absolutely the best mascara I've ever used. So I paid $22 for this at Ulta. This is about $3 more than their Bad Gal Lash Mascara, which I'm also a fan of, by the way. You guys know I love that mascara so much. So $22, yeah, it's pricey for a mascara, but to me, this mascara is absolutely worth it. Let me tell you guys a little bit about this mascara. The formula of this mascara is a glossy formula, so it makes your lashes look glossy, kind of like a, like a patent leather kind of look. Normally, I'm not a fan of glossy mascaras, but this actually works. It looks really good. So the formula is volumizing, lengthening, and curling. So you have all three things that you would look for in a mascara in this mascara, and it does all three things as promised. I still curl my lashes just because I have semi-long lashes naturally, so I still have to curl them, but it does curl them even more. I'm not gonna zoom in and show you guys what my lashes look like right now just because I'm wearing falsies right now because I just filmed a tutorial right before this, and I put this on over my false lashes, and oh my god, it's like almost too much. Anyway, so let me show you guys what this brush looks like, because other than the formula of the mascara, this brush really does make your lashes look much fuller. So it's a plastic, I think it's a plastic brush. It looks plastic and it feels plastic to me. But see, it's a long brush, and then there are, let me try it, there we go. And then the bristles are very short and there's a lot of them. And then you have this little thing at the top right here. It's like a little spiky thing. I don't even know how to describe that. But this little part right here, what that does is that grabs all the little lashes you have here in the inner corner and all the little baby lashes you have growing in the outer corner, so that it makes your lashes look a lot fuller, which I think is like a brilliant idea. The only thing when you're using this mascara that I would recommend is when you take the brush out of the little tube, wipe it off a little bit before you put it on your inner lashes, because as you can see here, it's kind of like gooped up a little bit. There's like a little bit of excess mascara right there. So if you apply that directly to your baby lashes right here, it's gonna clump up and you don't want that. So just wipe off the excess a little bit before you apply it and you're good to go. I have, I've actually gotten requests to review this mascara, and then I've also gotten requests to compare this to Bad Gal Lash, because a lot of you guys are like, well, I'm already wearing the Bad Gal Lash. It's $3 cheaper. That one's only $19. Should I switch over? I love Bad Gal Lash, and I personally am gonna switch over and start using this one, but it just depends on what you want out of a mascara. The Bad Gal Lash is still fantastic. I still love it. The difference with that one is a matte finish, first of all, so it's not glossy, it's matte. And also, I kind of find that my lashes are a little softer with this mascara, and with the Bad Gal Lash, they're a little firmer and more brittle, and I actually don't have a problem with that. Like I said, it just depends on what you want, and the Bad Gal Lash is very volumizing. It's not curling at all, and it does lengthen a bit, but it's mostly a volumizing mascara, so it just depends on what you're looking for. They're both great. I love both, but this is definitely gonna be my new mascara. So anyways, I hope you guys found this review helpful. If you have any further questions, anything I didn't cover at all, please address those questions down below in the comment section, or you can send me a message, or you can hit me up on Twitter or Facebook. So anyways, other than that, I'm gonna wrap this thing up because now Harmonica Dude has like a singer sitting with him. What is this, like a traveling band of hobos? You know, I don't even, and now there's bikers. I don't know what the hell is going on here, okay? I live in San Jose, downtown San Jose at that. This is a major metropolitan area. I don't know where we got banjos and harmonicas and bad singing and all this going on at the bus stop. I must have just stumbled into the wrong neighborhood when I got home last night. So anyways, thank you guys so much for stopping by to hang out with me. Don't forget to address your questions down below. I love you guys so much. And again, thank you so much for all your love and support. I will talk to you guys in the next video, and I hope you have a fantastic day. Bye.